25 years ago today, the Exxon Valdez ran aground off the Alaskan coast, spilling 11 million gallons of oil and forcing one of the biggest cleanups in U.S. history. Well, tonight there's a new cleanup after two ships collided in the Houston Ship Channel. 170,000 gallons of oil has leaked into Galveston Bay. Manuel Bohorquez is in Texas City tonight.
Scott, the vessel over my left shoulder is the barge that leaked the marine fuel. It's now surrounded by orange barriers to prevent whatever oil remains from flowing into Galveston Bay.
Seabirds covered in the heavy and sticky oil have been spotted along the bay. The spill happened at the height of roosting season close to a wildlife refuge near the accident site. Some of the oil has spread as far as 12 miles into the Gulf of Mexico. Rich Arnhart is with the state's response team.
What specifically makes it harder to clean up?
It's just a thicker oil. It stays together and it doesn't evaporate as fast as like some of the lighter crude oils or lighter fuel oils.
Conditions were described as foggy midday Saturday when the barge carrying that oil and a Libyan tanker collided. The barge was being pushed by the Miss Susan. Government records show the towboat, owned by Houston-based Kirby Inland Marine, has had three other collisions in the past 6 years. Two involved other vessels. U.S. Coast Guard Captain Brian Penoyer.
Visibility, the traffic, the meeting and crossing arrangements, all of those will be pursued completely.
A layer of black tar has covered nearby beaches and marinas. David Prater fishes these waters.
What's it like to see that?
It's very devastating. Yep, not good. That's just a small wipe. Look at that stuff, man, that's more and more.
Scott, there could be an economic cost to this as well, as cargo traffic at one of the nation's busiest ports has been put on hold. Nearly 80 vessels are waiting to get through the Houston Shipping Channel, and there's no timeline yet on when it might fully reopen.
Manuel, thank you.